Gabriel Garcia Marquez was a Colombian novelist, short story writer, screenwriter and journalist. Garcia Marquez, familiarly known as Gabo, in his native country, was considered one of the most significant authors of the 20th century. In 1982, he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature. He studied at the University of Bogotá and later worked as a reporter for the Colombian newspaper El Espectador and as a foreign correspondent in Rome, Paris, Barcelona, Caracas and New York. Marquez was born in the town of Aracataca, Colombia on 6 March 1927. Shortly after he was born, his father became a pharmacist and his parents moved away. The young Marquez was left in the care of his maternal grandparents. His grandfather, a veteran of Colombia's Thousand Days War and a liberal activist, gave him an awareness of politics. From his grandmother, Garcia Marquez learned of superstitions and folk tales. She spoke to him of dead ancestors, ghosts and spirits dancing round the house, all in a deadpan style that he would later adopt for his greatest novel. Garcia Marquez went to a Jesuit college and began to study law, but soon broke off his studies to work as a journalist. In 1954, he was sent to Rome on a newspaper assignment, and since that time, lived mostly abroad, in Paris, Venezuela, and finally, Mexico City. He always continued his work as a journalist, even when his fiction increased in popularity. Heavily influenced by the work of William Faulkner, Garcia Marquez wrote his first novel at the age of 23, although it took 7 years to find a publisher. Published in 1955, Leaf Storm and his three subsequent novels received critical acclaim from the literary establishment, but did not reach the wide audience he would win with his later books. In 1965, the idea for the first chapter of 100 Years of Solitude came to him while he was driving to Acapulco. He turned the car, drove home and locked himself into his room with 6 packets of cigarettes a day for company. He emerged 18 months later to find his family $12,000 in debt. Fortunately, he had 1,300 pages of phenomenal best-selling text in his hands. The novel's first printing in Spanish sold out within a week, and during the next 30 years, 100 Years of Solitude sold more than 20 million copies and was translated into more than 30 languages. The Chilean poet and Nobel laureate Pablo Neruda called the novel the greatest revelation in the Spanish language since Don Quixote. The New York Times called it the first piece of literature since the Book of Genesis that should be required reading for the entire human race. Following its publication, Garcia Marquez was asked to act as a facilitator in negotiations between the Colombian government and a number of guerrilla organizations including the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia, FARC, and the National Liberation Army, ELN. He also became friends with the Cuban leader Fidel Castro, a relationship that Garcia Marquez insisted was based on books. "Fidel is a very cultured man," he said in an interview. "When we're together, we talk about literature." In 1982, Garcia Marquez received the Nobel Prize for Literature. He received praise for the vibrancy of his prose and the rich language he used to convey his overflowing imagination. Some saw his work as deliberate exaggeration, a supernatural, mythical approach he affected to escape the unrest of his country. He said himself that surrealism came from the reality of Latin America, and such works as The General in His Labyrinth and The Autumn of the Patriarch illustrate his growing political opposition to the increasing violence in Colombia. Garcia Marquez's place in the ranks of literary masters was further assured by the publication of another best-selling work, Love in the Time of Cholera, in 1986. In the story of two couples, the younger based on their love affair between his own parents. The Mexican novelist, Carlos Macias, described Garcia Marquez as perhaps the best writer in Spanish since Cervantes. "He is one of those rare artists who succeed in chronicling, not only a nation's life, culture and history, but also those of an entire continent." To stay up to date with our latest videos and more short biographies, please make sure to hit on the subscribe button below. And until next time, have a great day.